our border. The power of the president of Nigeria is concentrated in a very sad interpretation of the power to look at the face of Pastor Ojo. He looked like the person that would do well to own an oil block. You would think that because that had now been challenged, because through the Nigeria Extractive Industry Transparency Initiative, how many of you hear about Meiti? Through the Meiti Act, we simply removed that and stated in that act, which is the regulator, the agency of Meiti is the regulator of the sector. We stated that everything about solid minerals, everything, in fact, in the case of solid minerals, I had gone to the sector. So the first thing that I did was to simply take away the discretionary power of the minister to issue licenses, exploration license. I said to them, I said, you think that sitting to give license is what my contemporary in Peru is doing? No, that's not what sensible ministers around the world do. They don't waste their productivity on transaction. They spend their time and their effort on vision. They envision. Then they strategize. And then they think about the kinds of policies and institutions that will deliver the right sets of results. Transactions is such a mundane activity that anyone with any iota of dignity will not bother themselves with. So I go to the sector, and every day I looked at, you know, the first 2 days, I looked at the CCTV, and I saw this room where there were so many people, just a lot of energy was in that room. And I was wondering, what do these people do in this place? So by the second day, I asked my secretary, I said, where is this room and who are these people? And she said, they are waiting for the minister. I said, minister, as in me? And she said, yes. So I said, so what are they waiting for? They are waiting for their exploration and mining license. I felt so sad. Because I said, so that's what this office is reduced to. To wait for people to come and talk about mining and exploration license. That's not the way the world functions. Knowledge is at its cheapest ever. The world has never seen knowledge so cheap in its history. You only don't know simply because you have chosen not to know. So what did we do? We sought the best knowledge for how I could free myself to be a minister that would envision, strategize, and enunciate policy and implement policy. And what did we do? We simply decided we were going to do a new legislation for the mineral sector. And I removed the power of the minister to award mining licenses. I took it away from the minister. And what did we do? Instead, we replaced it with what the world calls a mining cadastral. A mining cadastral is a technology-driven system of first come, first served. Use it or lose it. You don't have to talk to anybody. You simply go to the portal and you register, it will immediately capture what hour, what second of the day you registered an interest in a location based on data. Because we had done, one of the things we did in that reform was that we did an urban geophysical coverage of the entire nation. And so we had the data points available through the NGSA, Nigeria Geological Survey Agency. A gentleman, a great professional, Dr. Shio Malomo, who had been the head of geological survey at the Commonwealth, was glad to come home to serve his fatherland. And he became the great arrow head of the reform in terms of data availability. So once you had your data, and you marked a particular place that you thought there was possibility for exploration, you didn't need to come wait in the office of the minister. She had no time to talk with you. You simply went to the mining cadastral office, which we set up. And what did we do with that one? We brought the best person known as the best geologist in the field of gold expertise in West Africa, Professor Garuba. We brought him. He was the head of the geology department at the Ahmadu Bello University. He went to Madagascar, the first African country that had set up a similar platform for mining cadastral system. He went, learned everything possible to learn, and set up what is today a world-class mining cadastral system in this nation. You don't do it simply because you choose not to do it. So when I looked at the PIB and I saw Simon Kolawole, the journalist, I saw, where do you people go when you see things like that? I saw that the same power of discretion of the president to award oil licenses was very well protected and retained in the PIB that is being celebrated by those who are the architects of the continuation of this country being held hostage to poor governance of the oil sector. How can that be? How can that be? We are 52 years old. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, it was in April that I turned 50. So I said to my husband, it's like there are certain parts of my body now that don't function as they used to function in my 40s. And my husband said, 50 is not 40. Oh, Nigeria, 53 is not 3 years old. We can't repeat mistakes over and over and over again. All because we choose to not understand that good governance is the launch pad to greatness. You know, ladies and gentlemen, all that we need to do is to simply respect some of the institutions that we already have. I hear Nigerians have this conversation where they say, it's not about the individual, it's about the institution. It is neither nor. It is not a zero-sum game. You need competent individuals with character and with capacity to become the architects of the right kinds of institutional mechanisms. And when you create those agencies, they don't become institutions. You are a product of development study, Simon. You know that that inside